All right, Wichita Lineman, on your mark, get set, go. This is fun. F major 7, C11. F major 7, C11. So we're in the key of F here. Oh man, that's sounding good. So you're playing an F major 7, and that's the one chord, the tonic. And you're letting the open E string shine through. You get that major 7 sound. And then it goes to a C11. I'm just flopping into it. And you're just barring the top 5 strings and not really touching this. You could also like go like that and, you know, mute the 6th string with the tip of the index finger. So... oh, and then it's got that ding, ding, boom. Okay, we'll get to that later. So you got, we're in the key of F, and then let's see where it goes next. I am a B flat major 7, A minor 7, G minor 7. So there we're going to the 4th chord of B of the key of F. And this song is good for learning the key of F because I think it has all the chords except the E diminished, but it's got that, the 1, the F, it's got the 2, the G minor, and it's got the 3, the A minor 7, the 4, the B flat major 7, and it's using this C11 for the 5. And I should explain that probably, like, it's, if you look at a C chord, that's the root 3rd, 5th. And you're just piling on extended notes on top of it and adding a sus 4, but you've got a 7 and a 9. And in that situation, it's like 7 plus 4 equals 11. So you call it an 11. And, you know, you could even call it some kind of G minor 7 sus 4 over the 4 or whatever. It's just a big block of notes. And it adds a certain production value. We've seen it on a couple recent tunes, and a lot of bang for your buck. And so that verse progression starts on the B flat major 7, the 4 chord, and that's, you know, you can think of it like that, and you're just lowering that note, and it's index finger, so you make a little power chord, and then your middle finger goes onto the 2nd fret of the 3rd string, the 7th, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and then this goes on the 3rd fret of the 2nd string, and you get this nice, and the first, this finger is muffling that string, and you could also bar it like that, you could bar the whole thing and have like an ugly chord. So, but yeah, this trick of like thinking of a power chord and then extending it, and you can also just deaden that string and have like, kind of a weird chunky thing, sounds like the Cars, and an A minor 7, that's A minor with the open 3rd string ringing through, then we've got a G minor 7, and that is a bar on the 3rd fret, and then you add your ring finger on the 5th fret of the 5th string, 5th fret of the 5th string. And then, so that's that section. I'm a lineman for the county, and I drive the searching in the sun for another overload. We get into the minor here, D minor, the 6th chord, or relative minor. Searching in the, back to the 3, 4, now here, this is the 3 chord in F. A minor, F, 1, G minor, A minor, 3, 1, 2, 3. But this is also the 2 chord in G. 1, 2, 3. So you can see it's a common chord between the two keys. So it acts as a little pivot, and it allows Jimmy Webb to go to a G major, which if you're keeping track, you've been playing G minor, you know, or G minor 7. Now he goes to a nice big, bright, shiny G major, and it sounds brighter because you're sharpening one of the notes, you know, you gotta... Ooh, that sounds like the Hollies. But it's a different scenario. So what's happening here, man, is this section, searching in the sun for another overload. You got a D minor 7th, the 6th chord, going to the pivot chord, which is the 3 in F, but it's also the 2 in G. And now we're hitting the G major, which is the 1, and then overload, which is the D. And things are pretty ambiguous, but I'm calling this 2 in G. Now we're in the key of G, the 1, and then straight to the 5. And what happens is this little riff, like, and it lands that 5 chord again and establishes it as a tonal center at the end of the line. Just by dint of it being the resolvent or the final chord, it puts the tonal focus on it. So that means we're in the 5 of the key of G, the D's. Anybody know what that's called? It rhymes with Rixploitidian. Rixolydian. Mixolydian. And what happens is we kind of go in that, just kind of go in the walk down world. So it goes to this, you know, this version of C add 9, you know, from, if you know, G like that, where you're going, keeping these two fingers down, it's times they are changing, it's every Taylor Swift song. So you kind of walk here, and then you walk it down to here, but what happens is you keep walking it. Needle and the damage done, you know? A little bit. It hangs out on this chord a little more. So, we are getting away from being in G. We're on the... We land on the 5 chord, and then we do this walk down from the dominant. Now, some... might say, well, why aren't we in D? Well, it's because D's got a A major in it, and we've just been dealing with A minor. And if you even played a A major here, it would be like, whoa, you know. But don't worry, we're working our way there. So you're walking down. That riff is like, I hope I'm playing it right. I can hear you. I can hear you in the water. See, walk her down. Now you're in a G first inversion, but then whammo, right into a G minor. But the Wichita Lineman. You can walk that down to a D with an A underneath it. And, you know, that's a D in second inversion. And kablam, you get the A. But notice that there's a sus on there, so it's protecting you from getting the full blunt force of that C sharp. It's still on the, and you can, I think on the record, we should listen in a bit, but I think the sus doesn't even get resolved. It just, so what that is an A major chord, and you can put that note, you know, root, sorry, we're on root, third, and then you add a fourth. 1, 2, 3, 4, do re mi fa. Okay, so let's listen, and I'll call out the chords. Maybe I'll hit slow speed here, but I feel like, Oh yeah, and then the still on the line goes to the back to the B flat and then to the C add 9. We'll talk about that when we get there, because that's kind of like nice little solo. Here we go, so we're at slow speed. Here comes a C11 like that. Wrecking Crew. I am a lineman. D flat major 7. A minor 7 coming. I can really hear those notes. G minor 7. D minor 7. A minor 7. G major. The 5 here to the 4 a little bit. Oh, sir. Now it walks to B. B flat minor, or B flat to the D to the A sus. Small vacation. Still fast for being slow. So the little solo, this one actually I feel more inclined to do the Kurt Cobain B flat, but you could also use the B flat major 7 and you're just going down up up down up down up. Not a hard skill, but and you go to this, probably use, you could even like go like this. And then you do a, maybe a hammer on. Yeah, that's why I like this better, because you can go a little easier than that. So if you're with me on this, just get the muscle memory slow. So it's B flat to C major, C add 9, and then back to the C11, and I think we're off to the races. B flat, A minor 7, G minor 7, D minor 7, Connor, A minor 7, G. Here we are, a new key. C add 9. Can pick on it. The major 7 that time. I think that's Glenn Campbell himself. G minor 7, D minor 7, Connor. A minor 7, G major, D.
I need you more than more.
sorry. Should be that, probably. Get that jangle. Oh, this part changes. I think it just stays on that, though. Just goes into this David Bowie jam at the end. This would be a Lydian jam. Because Lydian is the fourth mode, and B flat there is the fourth chord. And it's just kind of shuffling between the B flat four chord to the C5 chord and never resolving to the one. Those days are done, man. Okay, so you know what we gotta get is this. So that is, you know, the thing about this song, the melody is kind of in the F chord, and you're moving around through different chords, but really the melody is like, you know, just pecking around the basic chord, and that's what makes it so kind of a bit of a fanfare or something like that. High on the line. So, oh yeah, but we're getting the intro actually. Dun, dun. So you're going B flat. And if you think of it as being part of the C11 chord, not a bad idea. You're right on the third fret, third string to the second fret, you know, part of F, and then to the root of F, and then open D, open fourth string, third fret of the fifth string, and then I'm thumbing it. Dun, 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 dun. Put on a nice heavy mute. I gotta turn up my volume. Man, maybe we should peck out the melody. Like, oh, this video is getting long. Well, here's the thing, man. I think if you're hanging on, I'm just gonna do this for you. So we've already got the intro melody. Yeah, the problem with landing that big juicy note is you lose the first beat of the chord. And or you could get rid of it. And then the melody is, so you're on the, so that's, most of it's within there, except for the sus, you know. So take a second and find that. And then you can just put it. So there I'm just slapping a bar on it and kind of getting that B minor tonality. Then it does more F on the A minor chord. It's like, so just find that with an in the main road. I'm not gonna give the answers for this because this is the part where you just find it within the chord. And then on road, it's on this chord. So if you notice, it's hitting a C over the G minor chord. So I'm gonna substitute that. Okay, so I am on my, nah. G. There I'm blocking that string. That way you get, I like this version of G, it's lean. And then, wow, I'm getting a lot of text. And then you do a little bend. It's like totally 90s. So maybe. My good friend Toot Caput, we've got a ridiculous collaboration going on, and I should turn my attention to that because you know, balance is everything. So in conclusion, you're in three keys, man. You're mostly in F, and then it kind of pivots into G, but mostly focusing on the D mixo part of G, the five chord, the a dominant chord, and then it walks down from the dominant through this chromatic passing flat note into the proper key of D finally, especially with that A there. And that's, I don't really hear that note, you know, they're still keeping a little ambiguity. So at that moment you're in D. We never talked about that actually. This is, you know, like you could perceive this as being the four chord of D, and this is the 5-1. And you know, you're going four and then you're altering. That's an alteration. You know, you're changing a major to minor, the major four to minor four, and then finally it's like still on the, and then it spits you out right back crunch where you started on a B flat. And you could call that an abrupt modulation, but there is a relationship between D and B flat. This would be the flat six, a commonly borrowed chord. So it's a tenuous relationship, but there's a common D, you know? And same with here. So you could say that solo is constructed around a drone pitch of D pivot point. Not really a pivot point, but like a... this video, if anybody's still watching, peace on earth, good will to men.